Welcome back to another video on the channel. My name is Delonte Freeman. This is SMB Fitness. And in today's video, I want to explain to you the importance of stepping up your body game. And I want to jump in it a little bit deeper, right? I covered the topic at least 3 or 4 times now, right? But I just keep on coming up with different, not ideas on it, but different reasons why this is an important topic, right? See, I don't know if there's a lot of young men that watch me or not. I'm not sure. But the ages range from like 17 to like 45. I did see that in the analytics, right? So, that being said, I want to make a video for the younger audience that's watching me, because I've been in your shoes before, right? And this body game stuff is pretty new to me. I'm not even going to lie. This is like my 3rd year of taking care of my body. So, it's pretty new to me, right? And this is why I would choose working out over anything else ever. Okay? See, number one, you can make a career path out of it, right? You can figure out how to monetize working out. If you really sit and think with yourself, you can figure out how to monetize and get paid off of working out as opposed to working for somebody else, right? Number two, it betters your mind, bro. It really do. Like, your mentality will get a lot stronger. And as you working out, you will want to beat yourself from last time, right? You will always want to get better. You just have to have that mentality, right? Sometimes you'll force yourself to do workouts and things that you don't want to do. And that reassures you that in your life, when you reach a certain level of obstacles, or when obstacles come your way, that you will always push through it no matter how much you want to. Because you do it with working out. So it's like you're used to that, pushing yourself through. You're used to giving yourself that self-push, that self-talk. You're used to getting through this obstacle that you don't really want to do. And me, before, I've taken a lot of different paths in life, you feel me? Like, I've done the financial part of life, trying to get a job, trying to sell substances, like illegal substances on the side. I've done a few things in my life to the point where I realized that this is the best path, you know? See, when you work in a job and you're getting females and you're attracting females based off the money and based off the image that you're portraying, right? Because when you get a certain amount of money, you like to buy certain things, and those certain things attract the female, right? And those are the wrong females that you want to attract. See, with body game, it's a little bit different. With having a nice body, a nice physique, you attract women based off your confidence, your charisma, your mindset. You know, all the things that are really less of material, you start to attract women based off those things of good character, good morals, and good principles that you stand by while taking care of your body. And those are the women that you really want to attract. You know, you don't want to really attract nobody that's in it for your wealth or your material possessions, because you think about it, everything in this life comes and goes. Everything, right? If you don't use the muscle, then the muscle will lose. You will lose the muscle, right? You don't use the muscle, you'll lose the muscle, right? So that's just about muscle. Well, think about money. Money has to flow through you, right? You have to pay for groceries. You have to pay for gas. You have to pay for shoes and clothes. You have to pay for haircuts. You have to pay for soap. You have to pay for washing powder. You have to pay for electricity. You have to pay for power, fire, air. You have to pay. Right? So money leaves you while you acquire it. It comes and goes, bro. And if a woman is attracted to you because of your financial status, then she's attracted to something that can possibly leave you. Right? She can come and go. So it's not really sustainable. You know what I'm saying? So you will want somebody that's attracted to you for your body based in, you know, over some money. Although you can't lose your body with age, right? Nobody stays the same forever, right? We get older, we get wrinkly, we have to die eventually, you know, but you can limit that process and allow your body to be in shape a lot more, just taking care of yourself and eating the right things. Also, I've done the street life and the street, you know, trying to rob and that image, right? I've done that, and I've had a lot of female attraction to me because of it, right? But in life, you gotta kind of bounce around to really see which path is the right path, right? And I'm just here to tell y'all that path is a no-no, bro. That path is dumb, you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like I was influenced by the music that we listen to in today's society, bro. The music will get you fired up and wanting to do certain things, and it only encourages you to do the wrong thing, You know what I'm saying? So when you got other people around you wanting to do the wrong thing, that's encouraging you to do the wrong thing. And then you finally get your hands on a gun because you just like guns. It's like everything else around you would like kind of evilize you and like kind of pervert you and make you want to do this street thing and start robbing and starting doing things in your own hands. But I'm here to tell you that that has bad karma, bro. And I don't believe in karma, but I do believe in everything reaping what you sow. I do believe in God giving you back what you've put out. Right? Now, if you sow a seed, an actual fruit tree, you go get fruit from that tree. You go get a tree and you go get fruit from the tree, right? If you sow an actual seed. So I believe if you sow evil into the world, you go get nothing but evil. You go see nothing but evil. I remember doing a lot of evil and I only seen evil. I only heard evil. I've heard who was getting robbed. I've heard who was getting shot at. And I've heard the negativity. I operated on that low vibration is what people like to call it. And that's all that I seen, bro. It's like now I'm kind of not in the middle, but I'm working my way out of that vibration. And all I'm seeing is like wealth. I'm hearing motivational speakers. I'm running to millionaires. And I'm working for people who have a lot of money and a lot of millionaires, a lot of wealth and a life that I actually want. You know what I'm saying? Now that I start working on my body and start choosing a more righteous path in life, you will start to see different things. You know what I'm saying? But you have to step out of that realm that you're already in and step into another place. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life, man. He saved my life. You know, like I was doing a lot of different things as far as like, you know, I won't say it. But yeah, man, I would choose working on myself over that image any day, you know. And a lot of the street dudes, a lot of the kids that like to play with the guns, they would think that it's corny, bro. Like, I can't even lie. I was one of those kids that thought it was corny because my surroundings thought it was corny. But my whole life, I've done football. I've done track. I've done wrestling. I've always played with my strength. You know what I'm saying? I've always started working on myself in some type of way and actually maximizing my physical attributes and my physical abilities until I got old enough to drop out of school, which is probably like 17. You're gonna have these fatigues, right? And spent about a year or two of my life doing the wrong thing. So then I started hanging around these kids, and it almost shifted and shaped it my mindset. That's another thing too. When you on this body game thing, you gotta leave people, bro. Like when you working on your body game and you coming up, you gotta leave people for real, bro. Cause when you think about it, bro, your surroundings, it plays a big part of your character, bro. Think about it. I want you to think of, like, you ever heard the saying, birds of a feather, they flock together. That is true. You know what I'm saying? You got the same feather, you go flock together, you go move together, right? You never see a pelican flying with a dove. You always see doves flying with doves, or you never see ducks. You know how ducks migrate in that V shape, right? You never see a turkey flying with ducks. They both birds, but what's the difference? One is a duck and one is a turkey. You know what I'm saying? So it's like it's a difference. You know what I'm saying? You need to upgrade and elevate once you start upgrading and elevating. Like, you can't elevate and upgrade physically without doing it spiritually. You know, everything happens in your spirit first before it happens in your physical realm. You know, and you can always work on the physical, but the spirit is overnight. The spirit happens instantaneously, right? And yeah, bro, like, don't ever feel like it's corny or lame to actually go in the right direction. You know, you because later in life you will regret it if you live to see like 40 or 50. Like, I speak to a lot of 40 or 50 year olds because I'm curious. You know, I ask a lot of questions and I care about people, right? And I care to know about people's story. So I ask questions, you know, and a lot of people in my hood, a lot of older people in the hood, or a lot of older people that I might meet out and about or on the street, or a lot of people that done some jail time, they always regret it. They always, man, don't do that, bro. I'm telling you. But they not saying it because it's cool. Like, some idiots still think it's cool at 40, 50. But then you got some people who saying it, like, because they genuinely want you to not do it, bro. But you, as an individual, you go look at this person's life and be like, kind of cool, because you get the girls, he got this image, he got this demeanor, you know, but it's different, bro. You can have that same demeanor and image with just working on yourself right now, today. Don't go to jail, bro. Do not waste your life on doing the wrong things, because you don't have a life to waste. You only get one life. So why would you waste one? You're not a cat. And I don't even think Cat gets live, not 9 lives. That was just something I like to say. This ain't GTA, bro. You can't respawn, bro. You can't come back here, bro. So it ain't no point of wasting it. Do the things that you want to do in this life. If you want to waste your life and jump in the streets, go ahead, bro. By all means, necessarily, go ahead. You know, but me personally, I want to enjoy my life. I want to see the bigger things and the better things out of life. You know what I'm saying? Not even just play with money, but I want to play with freedom. Explore the world, you know? Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. I thank everybody for watching this video. That was a brief explanation and a brief summary and a brief, you know, whatever on why I would choose Body Game over any other path in life, bro. I've done a lot of paths. I've went down a lot of paths. And this is the right one, I'm telling you. And with that being said, man, like, comment, and subscribe on this video. Share this video. Share this content, bro. We on our way to 1,000 subscribers, and we need 4,000 watch hours, bro. I'm not gonna lie, bro, the watch hours are looking crazy, so I need y'all to watch these videos and go back and watch other videos. Right now, we should be at the end of the video, so just click one of the options. With that being said, man, I'm out. Peace.